everyone, this is Shreeja. Welcome to Skinoreal, where I talk all things skincare. So if you like skincare related content, then make sure that you subscribe. Likewise, you can also follow me on Instagram, where I post more regularly. Now, this is one of the most requested videos, and I don't even want to, you know, stall around. I just get straight into the video. So today's video is about what I eat in a day. Now, I would like to make this video about what I eat on a regular day, because I make sure that I eat, my two meals are from outside every single week, because of course I'm a human and I have a taste bud and I also enjoy certain things. There are, like, you know, unhealthy foods that I enjoy. I'm not gonna beat myself about it, but yeah. So, but more or less this video is only focused on what I eat on a regular day. Like, I'll talk about what I like to eat when I go out and on weekends, like towards the end of the video. So yeah, let's just get straight into it. So in the morning, my day starts pretty early, say about 5:30. Between, like, I get up between 5:30 to 6, and then straight off I like to work out. It's a 1 hour workout, which is like a combination of yoga and Pilates, and I also alternate it with high intensity interval training, like depending upon how I'm feeling. But without fail, I work out every single day for at least an hour. And once I'm done with my workout, I rush to take shower. But before shower, I consume soaked methi seeds with water every single morning. You have to soak 1 teaspoon of methi in a glass of water and leave it overnight and consume it first thing in the morning. I have been doing this for about 3 to 4 months now. You know, there was no particular reason that I started this ritual. The thing is, methi is extremely rich in antioxidants and in iron. And since the time I started taking it, I have seen that overall texture of my hair has improved, and I just feel less bloated. So yeah, I like to start my day with this, and it has just become like a ritual for me. There's a very popular trend of consuming lemon water in the morning. I used to do that, but then I developed lemon allergies, and unfortunately I can't drink that. So then I switched to methi water, and I really like it. But of course, you will need to be consistent if you need to see results with it. Now, moving on to the next thing that I actually consume, and that is after my shower, I consume 5 soaked almonds before my breakfast. Like, I'm not a huge fan of nuts, to be honest, and just consuming it first thing during the day sort of, you know, just helps me to get whatever healthy fats that I'm trying to get from the nuts and just get it out of the way. Like, I like other forms of nuts, but I'm not a huge fan of almonds, so I just like to take it before my breakfast. And now for my breakfast, I love South Indian food, so either it's uttapam or dosa, or it's avocado toast, eggs, and a sandwich. In the sandwich that I like to eat, it's like it has a mixture of cheese, onions, tomatoes, and things like that. And I like to eat 1 egg. I also like to mix it, make my own hummus at home and avocado dip at home to sort of make like a sandwich platter. But yes, and I really don't eat anything else for breakfast. I just keep alternating between dosas and my eggs and breads. That's about it. So for me, breakfast is like a very no-fuss meal, and I really don't like to think a lot about it. So I just keep alternating between these two particular form of say cuisine or whatever. But yes, I also sometimes do take poha, but that is very rare. Now, then I start working around 9. Like 9 o'clock, yes, I'm done with my breakfast and I start working. I take my consultations, and say about around 11:30 to 12, I have a portion of fruit. And it's usually seasonal fruit. I don't eat fruits that are not in season, and I consume like any sort of fruit. I also like to drink a green tea or my Cosmix mix at that point of time. I sometimes also sprinkle Cosmix mix on food. Currently I'm taking What Women Want and Good Skin from Cosmix, so I like to sprinkle it on the fruits, and I also like sometimes also make a herbal tea and I drink it. But yeah, around 12 I do that. Apart from this, I also eat pecans. I don't know how you say it, it's pecans, but whatever, I'm gonna say it. So I like pecans because they're like a little bit sweet, and so yeah, I'll have 2 portions of pecans along with my fruits, and sometimes I also consume coconut water, but that's about it, nothing too heavy. It's either coconut water or some herbal tea, some fruit or something like that. Then after that, at 2, between 2 to 2:30, I have my lunch, and I'm not really, again, very picky about my lunch. I like variety. Like, I'm not someone who will keep eating dal, chawal or roti sabzi every day. I get very bored. So I sometimes alternate between Mexican food, either it's quesadillas or some form of rolls. I also love chicken tikka rolls. I love biryani. Then all of it. Then I also like to eat dal, chawal, rice. I love theplas. So it's like a mixture of cuisine. But keep in mind, whatever I consume, everything is cooked at home. So everything is cooked in a very healthy and proportionate way. Nobody uses refined oil. We don't use refined oil at all. Everything is either cooked in coconut oil, ghee or mustard oil. Yeah, that's what we use. And even when we are making biryani or we are making rolls at home, like not, when I say we, it's my mom. I'm not good at cooking. So even when she's making quesadillas and things like that, it's not like it's loaded with cheese or unhealthy sauces and things like that. I even prefer making my dips at home because the ones that you get outside are just loaded, like full of preservatives and unloaded calories, which I just don't like to consume on a regular basis. So definitely what I'm trying to say is that, you know, you can take whatever form of food that you like and just make a healthier version at home if you have time, of course. Like, honestly, if I would be living alone, I would not have been able to do all of this. Because I remember when I was living alone in London, I used to either eat like a salad or alternate between khichdi or some basic sabzi. But I do try to eat healthy as much as I can. But by healthy, I don't mean that I'm not someone, I'll not eliminate carbs or protein and things like that from routine. By healthy, I don't mean turning vegan or going on like on a keto diet. By healthy, I mean like whatever is available, home-cooked meals and eating everything in a proportionate way. So after lunch, I love desserts and I don't consume dessert every day, but I eat like a mini piece of chocolate or like some portion of home-cooked cake again. Like, I love oat cakes that you make at home. Like, my mother makes this delicious apple and oat cake and I love it. So like a portion of cake, a portion of chocolate, or in fact if nothing is available, I'm also fine with eating like a piece of jaggery. But I need something sweet in the afternoon, and I'm not trying to really, you know, say that yes, I know sugar is bad for me, but then I also understand the fact that, you know, if I become extreme, I won't be able to follow anything. So I like to strike a moderation as much as possible, and I like to have that little bit of you know, like a small dessert or a treat in the afternoon. Then again, I start walking until evening. I'm walking. And then around, say, 6:30, I will have like a cup of tea. When I say cup of tea, I drink black tea with a little bit of milk and sugar. Instead of regular sugar, I have started alternating white sugar with monk sugar for my teas. So monk sugar is like a form of sweetener that is derived from monk fruit. It's extremely sweet. You need 2 to 3 drops. But the unique thing about this monk sugar is that the sweetness in the fruit doesn't come from sugar. It comes from an antioxidant. So it's, in the long run, it's good for you and it's much better for you rather than consuming plain white sugar. So of course I have a cup of tea, and if I'm feeling too hungry, I'll eat like an omelette or like a slice of bread or a portion of fruits or a little bit of makhanas. I don't like to munch on chips and all these snacks and things like that. I'm not shaming you if you do. Honestly, it's about personal choice. I have never been like, I have sweet tooth. I have never been like, since child, like I have never been a huge fan of chips and things like that in my entire life. So it's just not something I like. I would rather eat like a portion of bread or like roasted makhanas and things like that. And yes, also in the morning as well, after my breakfast, I like to consume a cup of black tea with milk. I think tea is my guilty pleasure. I cannot stay without this tea. I absolutely love it. No matter what kind of herbal tea I'm drinking, I need to have this tea. I'll link the one that I'm talking about. It's just with less milk. I personally don't like Indian chai a lot. I used to drink it in London, but I sort of got addicted to it, and that's when I realized that, you know, it's not something good for me. If I just don't drink this tea, I'm fine. I don't get headaches, but with the Indian chai, like, I used to get headaches and it sort of started creating acidity. So that's the reason I switched to this tea. Everyone in my family actually drinks this tea, and just try it once. I might actually share a recipe as to how to make it. It actually tastes very refreshing and it's very similar to the Indian tea. So it's not something that is completely without milk, without sugar and things like that. Okay, now moving on to my dinner. For my dinner, I really prefer eating something very light. I'm not a dinner person. You know, I'm really excited about my breakfast, my lunch, but dinner, I'm really not that excited about. So either it's oats, it's khichdi, it's some form of roti sabzi. I also like to eat some form of stuffed roti with paneer or things like that for dinner. And then I, before going to bed, I consume olive seeds with a little bit of milk. Yeah, that's all I consume on a regular day. Now, when I'm going out, I go out twice. Like at least two of my meals are from outside, and when I'm going out, I like to eat. I love pastas, I love pizzas, so I love to eat pastas. Pizzas I try to replace, like, but keep in mind I try to eat whole wheat pastas or semolina pastas, like, you know, healthy crust pizzas as much as possible. Of course, there are days, you know, when you're not gonna get those, but yeah, that's what I do. I try to find healthy options wherever I can. I also love Thai food. So I eat Thai food, I love veg sushis, I can't eat fish. I'm not a huge fan of burgers, so that's not something that I like. Another thing that I mean, like, I love is, like, I love Big Chill Cakery and I love eating their desserts. So once a week, of course, I go out and I share like a slice of cake with my friends. But yeah, I make sure that I don't deprive my body of anything. So at least, you know, I'm not binging on anything. The thing is that, you know, if you deprive your body of anything, it can sort of lead to deprivation and then you're gonna binge eat. And honestly, I'm not a happy person if I don't eat well. So for me, eating is very important. I love food. Like, I don't like a lot of variety, but in general, I do like food. So yes, for me to be happy, I need to keep eating. And yeah, that is all. I do take supplements also, like few supplements. There's an IG post about the supplements that I take, so feel free to go through that. And if you have any questions for me, please feel free to drop them in the comments below. And I will see you next time. Bye.